Jesus, who are the Word made flesh, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the way to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you. reading for the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, hearing with one, bearing with one another, and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all these, put on love, that is, the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were also called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of God, Christ, dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs, with gratitude and remorse to God. And whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Wives, be subordinate to your husbands, as is proper to the Lord. Husband, love your wives, and avoid any bitterness toward them. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this is pleasing to the Lord. Fathers, do not provoke your children, so they may not become discouraged. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. There was also a prophetess, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel,
child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the letter of Paul to the Colossians today, we find one of the verses that some women find offensive. Wives, be subordinate to your husbands as is fitting in the Lord. The Greek verb which Paul is using for to subject oneself is hupotasso, which means to place oneself under the authority of another. Unfortunately, some Christian groups have used this verse as an excuse for total domination of a husband over his wife, as if she were his slave, and has no say whatsoever in the goings-on of her own family. I don't think that's what St. Paul had in mind when he wrote this letter to the Colossians. So, I'm going to look at some other material, because this is not the first time Paul wrote about this issue in the New Testament. For example, in the letter of Paul to the Ephesians, chapter 5, verse 21, Paul says this, "Be subordinate to one another out of reverence for Christ." Again, there's that same verb, hupotasso. Here, Paul is saying that all members of the family should defer to one another, respect each other, place the other's needs first. In other words, we should not be selfish people, self-absorbed. We should be looking out for the needs of other people in the family, and then try to do something to help those needs when that is necessary. Then we are to do all of this out of love for Christ. Now, the Greek in the Colossians letter has at least one grammatical difficulty in it. So translation of it is harder. But hear what Paul has to say after he says that his wife should be subordinate to the husband in all things. Because the rest of what Paul says there doesn't fit well with the interpretation that the wife should basically be the slave of the husband. I mean, if you read the entire passage, you could not possibly take that away from that one verse that appears to say something like that. Now, I was going to go through the Greek, but I have to admit that I am not as good at pointing Greek today as I was 20 years ago. And also, I'm sick. So, I'm just going to read from a couple of paragraphs from the Catholic Catechism on this matter. The Christian family is a communion of persons, a sign and image of the communion of the Father and the Son in the Holy Spirit. In the procreation and education of children, it reflects the Father's work of creation. It is called to partake of the prayer and sacrifice of Christ. Daily prayer and the reading of the Word of God strengthen it in charity. The Christian family has an evangelizing and missionary task. The relationships within the family bring an affinity of feelings, affections, and interests arising above all from the members' respect for one another. The family is a privileged community called to achieve a sharing of thought and common deliberation by the spouses, as well as their eager cooperation as parents in the children's upbringing. So you see, the catechism says something to the effect there that authority within the family, especially in the raising of children, is shared between the man and the wife. That it's more or less equal, and gist of, I mean, the church's teaching on this matter. Now, in the gospel, the picture painted of the Holy Family is one where religious practice is extremely important to this family. As Jews, they follow the law of Moses in offering their firstborn son at the temple. The Gospels show that this pattern was followed by that family throughout their lives, and by Jesus when he finally began his public ministry some 30 years later. But in today's passage, Simeon tells Mary that Jesus will be a sign that will be contradicted, the rise and fall of many in Israel, and that Mary's heart would itself be pierced by how people react to her son. Now, what did he mean by that? You see, the thing about Jesus is that either you accept him as Messiah and Lord, or you don't. There are consequences either way. Maybe the sword which pierced Mary's heart was the fact that so many of her own people would not accept Jesus. A fact which led to his crucifixion. And of course, Mary was there from the beginning to the end of that, even handling his body as she took him on the cross, as you see in the beautiful work from Michelangelo, the Pieta, that statue, marble statue. Never get a chance to see that in life, see it. I actually saw a woman while I was there break down in tears, just looking at the detail that was involved there, the obvious love and care that was behind it, and just what it speaks to the world of a mother losing her son in the way that she did. Well, anyway, the same choice goes for our time. We can accept or reject Jesus and his message. Now, I guess it's possible to say that we accept Jesus, that we are Catholic, but then to have nothing in our lives to back that claim up. But I have to tell you, the consequences of that action do carry with it consequences. The God who made us and then redeemed us wants us to be in relationship with him. He clearly wants us to be part of what he refers to as his family. And the quality of that relationship can affect greatly how our life goes. People who are serious about following Jesus treat each other in a certain way, like Paul says. Remember, there's a passage in one of the Gospels where Jesus is in a house, and then someone comes inside to tell him, "Your mother and your brothers are outside waiting." And he responds to that person, "Who is my mother? Who are my brothers?" The one who does the will of God is mother and sister and brother to me. So if we want to be of the family of God, we need to try to follow his will in everything. So do we stand with Joshua from the Old Testament, who said, "As for me and my household, we will choose the Lord"? Or by our actions, do we choose something else? Let's stand up.
Father, in the name of Jesus,
Listen now to the prayers of your family and grant them the final to your will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please join us in the offertory song 695, above the hill.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer. Through the earth, the work of human hands, you become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer. Through the divine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual bread. Father, and the Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For on the Exalt up all the angels we praise you as in joyful celebration. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I thank you. Next Sunday will be the first Sunday of the month, so there will be airplane inmate Sunday. If you would like to buy a ticket for the new event, I have tickets in my office. Join us for coffee donuts in the East Wing after Mass today. Why do I want to wish you a happy new year? Let's pray. Bring those in refreshment of this heavenly sacrament, most merciful Father, to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world, we may share our company forever through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, Father, and Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The fourth message.
Thank you. almost up to being 20 in Durham for 3 days. And then they started leaving. It was crazy. All those babies.
Yeah.
Like, what babies are you doing? And they're crying. It's horrible. Somebody's
taking your mom.
Can I go get that one?
No, that was supposed to scream.
Okay. Happy New Year. Practicing strong on God's side.